Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft Viking Heritage. Yeah, it's a big day today and I'll talk about that a little bit later. But why is this video called 3-in-1? Yeah, it's because I have three different things I want to show you. First, I would like to show you a video from a Viking village that is located here in the northern part of Jutland, near a little town called Tornby. And it's a little pearl because it's in the woods and it's not easy to find. You have to have a map and go for that. But in this little woods, there's a little magic Viking village that I have visited and made a video about. It's only 7 minutes long and I hope you'll watch it because, I think you'll like it. And the next thing is, I got some new axes recently and I made a review of those. And yesterday I was out in my camp and tested these axes and I made a review video about that. And that will be the next video after the Viking Village. And last but not least, my 75,000 subscribers giveaway. Yeah, I reached the 75,000 subscriber a couple of days ago, and I'm so happy and so grateful for all your support you're giving me. And have previously announced that I will make a giveaway, and this is a big giveaway. I have 6 items that I will give away, and 3 of the items are from my the company that I am an ambassador for, 2 from myself I made, and the last one is from an awesome company that make some awesome gear for bushcrafting. So yeah, so after these videos from the Viking Village and from my axe review, I'll get back to you and tell you about my 75,000 subscribers giveaway. Hope you enjoy.
And it is these three axes that I got recently. I'll make a review of and test them. The first one is a skeg ox, Grimfrost skeg ox, the big one, and this is skeg ox, the small one. I'll tell you a little bit about that a little bit later. And this is called a Ragnar axe. And these two are from Grimfrost, and this one I bought on the internet. I'm not sure I'm going to tell you where you can buy this. It depends on how it goes when I'm testing it. I did some testing and they were not good, so let's see. But this one, of course, I've customized the sheet myself, so it looks a little bit more old school. There you are. So, this is the beast. It's very heavy. I write down here how much it weighs. This is a medium size. It weighs a lot of 2 because it's very thick here. And this one is light and very handy. You've seen me recently make videos where I use this for small chopping. And this one I won't test today because I've done that and I know it's a very good axe and it can perform very well. And it keeps its edge nicely. So, but these two I'll start with and chop in some wood and see how they perform. Yeah. And first I'll use the Ragnar. Okay, and then I'll use the Grimfrost. Yeah. And for me, there's no doubt that this egg from Grimfrost is much better than this one. But, and now to the next test. And again, first the Ragnar. Yeah. It's very good splitting wood, and it's because it has this profile. It's very thick and very fast. So for splitting wood, it's awesome. And I use that in my shelter overnighter with Martin, and it performed well there too. So now to the Grimfrost X. See if we can do it just as good. Not the same. Oh yeah. Also good. I find another one. One more time on the other side, right there. Yeah, come on. Yeah. There you are. Whew, and with a piece with a lot of nuts in.
Yeah. Not bad at all. There you are. Yeah. Yeah, so good. The Ragnar. Yeah. Let's see how it looks. If there are any chipping in these axes. Let's see this Ragnar. It's very difficult to focus so close. So I don't think you can see anything. But I can. I can, and it looks pretty good. Yeah, it's a little bit there, but nothing that a quick sharpening can. What about this? Yeah. Nothing neither.
So my conclusion is, it didn't surprise me that these two axes perform very well, and of course I chose them because of the looks and the history that are in these old Viking axes, and see if I can use them when I'm out making firewood and so on. And this one is very good for small tasks, and yeah, I love using it. It's very light, but again, have a good grip. These two axes, I changed the profile in the handle. It comes, you can see in the picture, it's straight, the handle, but I chose to make it like this, tapered down here. I think that's, yeah, it gets a good grip, and the same with this axe. And yeah, it performs very well. Yeah, and it didn't surprise me because Grimfrost makes quality stuff, so I knew that this was would be a great axe, and I actually, I've been looking for an axe like that, and that's why I bought this. And then I found out, well, Grimfrost had them, why look elsewhere? So I got this one and this one. It's hard on the picture to see how big they are. So I bought this first and thought, well, it's cool, but it's a little bit small for larger pieces of wood. So this one surprised me, it's so big, yeah. I really love it. And then for this one, the Ragnar Lockbrook axe. I didn't expect it to perform as well as it actually do. So yeah, if you like the design here, it's a medium axe, you can see, compared with the two other axes. And the only thing about this axe is I bought it and on Etsy, and I don't want to buy things anymore from out of the European Union, because I'm going to pay a lot of taxes. I explained that previous in this video. So I look for an axe, and axe like this, and on Etsy I find one in Barcelona. Yeah, well, I thought it was in Barcelona, but actually it is made in Pakistan and came from Pakistan. So I had to pay a lot of custom duty taxes for this too, so this is no good. And I'm not particularly fond of the steel that they use in Pakistan. I think it's a little bit too soft for my kind of work. But again, I can't see anything here, and yeah, I'm not the best reviewer in the world, I know that, but I hope you got a little idea about these three axes and which axes I prefer to use. This is brand new, I used that a couple of times, and this even more. So I'll test them on my next adventures and see if they can see if they are as good as I expect them to be. And again, I made changes in these two handles and all three sheets that comes with these axes. So this is not the sheet you are getting, but you can make them like this if you are able to work a little bit with leather color and yeah.
And one more thing, if I'm out in the forest and have to cut down a little tree, I don't think this will perform very well, but I definitely think that this one would. So the Skagox from Grimfrost wins in that competition. And if I'm going to split wood, hardwood, this one is the one I will choose.
And as you can see in the video, it's from a little Viking village called Yxengard, or Yxengård. Here in Denmark we have this letter, O it is called, and if you take two A's, it makes O in Danish. So Yxengard is Yxengård, and gård is a yard or something, and yeah, many Midgard and all this thing from the Nordic mythology. So that's the reason why it's pronounced that way. And the man that have created this little paradise for role play and Viking stuff has made this from the ground, and some people have come and helped him. But I'll put a link to the video and the website so you can read about it there. Unfortunately, I don't think it's in English, but you get a picture of how big it is and what kind of stuff they are doing there.
In my review of the Viking axes, of course, the Grimfrost Skagox, I like them very much, but the one that I bought on Etsy surprised me a little bit. It was a better quality than I had expected, so I put a link to Etsy and his page. So if you want this axe, even though it's from Pakistan, you can buy it there. I have to say, when I bought it, it was much cheaper than it is now, so I don't know if his price will drop again, but you could ask him. Yeah. Oh yeah, I reached the 75,000 subscribers, and this is my giveaway. It's awesome. I'm so grateful for all the kindness and support all your friendly subscribers and friends out there are giving me. It's because of you and your kindness that my channel has grown so much, and I really appreciate all the nice comments that are giving me, and I'm glad that most of you are interested and think that my Viking theme are exciting to hear about, and I'll continue on that track along with normal bushcrafting and stuff out from my Cimbrer camp. Yeah, but again, I'm so grateful. Thank you very much, all my wonderful subscribers. Yeah, as I said in the beginning, I'm an ambassador for three awesome companies: Grimfrost, PNW Bushcraft, and LEMMEL Coffee. And these three companies have donated an item for my giveaway. I'll take the first one. It is from Grimfrost, and as you can see here, it's a comb made of bones. It's a birka comb, and it's a replica of a finding in Sweden in Birka. And I put a link to it on my video description so you can find. There's a lot of details about how it was found, and I think Grimfrost was making a replica for that, and I think it is on exhibition in a museum. But nevertheless, it's an awesome comb. It's for a man, and I can tell you that because they got some, they made some DNA samples from the comb, probably from his hair, and found out it was a man that had this comb. So yeah, it's an item from the Viking Age, and those of you who are interested in that, I think you will be very happy for that. And other people, if you're a woman, you can use it for combing your hair, or a man combing your beard. So it's a really nice gift, and I'm very grateful for Grimfrost that they are donating this for my giveaway. Thank you very much, Grimfrost. PNW Bushcraft is donating this cedar bucket bag with outside pockets featuring the Death Bunny leather patch. Yeah, it's a great little item. I love it. And yeah, I got something similar. You all seen that in my bushcraft video. I use it for my cooking utilities. Inside you can have
a pot or a little stove, and outside you can have all these things that you use when you are cooking your food. You can use it for other stuff too, of course, but it's an awesome product, and I know that PNW Bushcraft always make quality stuff. So if you win this pouch that is on this picture, I'm sure you'll be very happy for that. And I'm very grateful for PNW Bushcraft donating this item for me. They have been with me for a long time. I think they donated something for my 5,000 subscribers giveaway or something like that. So it's a company that have supported me for a very long time, and I want you to support them. Go into their website again. I'll put a link in my video description. Yeah. And then the third thing is from LEMMEL Coffee. Most of you know that I have drinking LEMMEL Coffee. It's coffee from the northern part of Sweden, and it's an awesome coffee, and it tastes very delicious. And recently I got some whiskey coffee from them, and it's even more delicious. And LEMMEL Coffee is donating this little package, and inside here there is a fire striker. I take you closer, you can see. You can see here, there's a fire striker and the fire steel, and the fire striker is also a bottle opener, and there's the logo from LEMMEL, and I've burned in to the fire steel my Cimbrer Bushcraft logo. So yeah, it's a very special gift, and I know the one that are winning this will be very grateful for that. It's an awesome little fire striker and steel, and it works perfectly. So I'm very grateful for LEMMEL that they are donating this for my giveaway, and I'm very grateful for all the support they are giving me too. And go in and check their website. I think they are selling to more and more countries outside this northern part of Europe, so go in and check them out. And now for the next couple of gifts. And it's something that I made myself. I made this little spoon. I carved in birch wood, and of course I burned in my logo Cimbrer Bushcraft here. So this is a prize too you can win. A little spoon carved by me. And the second thing is, yeah, this little Viking bag that I made some month ago. I also have a tutorial where I show how I made this, and it's in my very popular video, my Viking belt kit video. Yeah, so, and I burned in here again Cimbrer Bushcraft. I take a little bit closer, and you can see here, so you can see it's me that are donating this. And I've got a lot of requests for making these for some friendly subscribers, and I'm not in a position to do that. So yeah, the one that are winning this, I hope they'll be glad for it, and I hope they will appreciate the work I'm put into this. And and last but not least, this little awesome piece of gear. Yeah, BDBQ. It's a grill, and I told you about this before, but I can't tell you enough. It's one of my best gear I ever had. When I'm out making my bushcraft videos in camp or elsewhere out in nature, and I have to grill some meat or something, I always use this, and I'll just put it on here on the table so you can see how it works. And yeah, go in and check them out. This gear is one of the coolest gear I ever had. Comes in this bag, and of course the winner is getting a new one. This is mine, and I used it a lot, as you can see, but it doesn't take much room, and you just fold it out here like this and fold up the legs here, and there's a click system, so they'll be there. Yeah, and then it can stand for itself, and the most awesome thing is you can make it double size. Yeah, so this grill from BDBQ is one of the prizes that I've been donated for my giveaway, and I'm so grateful for that. And I know that they are having a kind of sale on Amazon, and I put links to that and their website so you can see. And another thing, cool thing, if if the fire is too small or something, you can just adjust the legs here, put it lower down like this, then it's lower, and you can make it, of course, even lower than this, like this. Yeah. So it's a very versatile grill, and in real good quality. And you can see in these pictures, I've used them in my Cimbrer camp many times, and it's always working perfectly. And another thing with this grill, when you do this, you almost clean it every time. For the big pieces of food that is on here, it will vanish with this. It'll go away. Go in, check them out. BBQ from Canada. Yeah, and this is all for now. I'll say that the 24th of September, I will end this giveaway, and a couple of days after that, I'll make a video so and draw the winners of this these 6 prizes in my giveaway. And it will be like this. I use a random common picker, as I usually do, and then I'll write 6 notes or 6 pieces of paper and put it in a little container. And then the first winner I'll pick down in the pots and take up a piece of paper, and the winner will win the item that I have written on this piece of paper. Yeah, I hope you understand what I'm meaning, but that way it's random which winner is winning a certain prize.
And so, if you want the opportunity to win one of these 6 prizes, you have to be a subscriber for my channel, and you have to write "I'm in" the comment section.
Before I go, I have to say another thing. I have to stop receiving items for you, my wonderful subscribers, and for companies outside the European Union. The European Union has made new rules regarding import or packets that are coming from other countries than here in the European Union. That means that almost everything that I get, I have to pay a lot of money in taxes and stuff and so on, and I just can't afford that anymore. So don't send me any more items. I'm sorry it has to be that way, but I have a couple of stories. I have a friendly subscriber from Japan that sent me something. It was 1.5 months before I got it. It was in Denmark, but the customs services were not quick, so it lasted 1.5 months before I got it, and then I also have to pay for it. And a friendly subscriber for England, UK, that sent me stuff, and yeah, I had to pay for that, but I don't know why, but even though I have paid for it, they sent it back to the sender. So, and I have to fill out a lot of formulas and papers only to try to get my items, and it's very seldom that they accept my arguments. So every time, almost every time, I have to pay for these things. So yeah, that's the way it is. I just can't afford to get all those free gifts from you. I'm sorry for that, but that's the way it is. Yeah, hope you understand that. Yeah, thank you for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft. I really appreciate that, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye, and take care.